Growth of technology globally is fast. In Uganda, such growth has led to the introduction of different digital solutions that promote access to financial products and services. However, digital solutions, if not well regulated, give chance to fraudsters to operate in the same financial environment where former authorized businesses operate.
It is the private sector that has made it possible for us to be able to talk about financial inclusion. The phenomenon of transferring money across mobile phones was by and large made possible by the investments of the private sector. In saying that, there are many, many areas that need to be regulated or where we need policy guidance.
This MOU with the Ministry of ICT reaffirms our belief that technology is both going to disrupt and power how we use financial services in the future. Regulatory jurisdictions are going to get blurred, requiring regulators across departments and agencies to come and work together, balancing the needs of prudential regulation without sacrificing innovation.
But one would wonder about government's interest towards financial inclusion given the recent announcement and implementation of the mobile money tax. Bajire says taxes are good for the country, but money from tax should be well utilized.
I support the tax by and large, but I support it to the extent that it is reasonable. And I think 0.5% that has been proposed is something we should be comfortable with. And I hold a view that with 0.5%, we shouldn't have a problem, because the reality is, it's true we want financial inclusion, but at the same time, as a developing country, we the citizens must pay our taxes.
The Memorandum of Understanding is for 2 years and formalizes the partnership between the ICT Ministry and DFID-funded Financial Sector Deepening Uganda in facilitation, promotion and development of policies, laws, regulations and infrastructure to support inclusive digital financial services in Uganda.
We talk about Moody's rating, one of the top rating agencies.
Relatedly, the Deputy Governor of Bank of Uganda, Dr. Louis Kasekende, cautioned financial sector players, especially commercial banks, to innovate and reduce cost of doing business.
Costs of delivering services, because at the end of the day, it keeps lending rates at a very high level. So we should be doing more to reduce the costs of doing business in Uganda.
What we've seen is the cost of doing financial transactions, which I would say has been brought down by digitization. When I showed the number of agency transactions that are happening, I highlighted that that's an infrastructure that we have laid for both our clients, for government agencies, for anybody doing financial intermediation, is a railway line that you can hook on and transport your goods and services, because it gives empowerment to mobilize the cash on the cash economy.
The Bank of Uganda Deputy Governor also explained the role of the central bank in regulating and ensuring commercial banks provide financial services in a safe environment.
Represent and protect the interests of the depositors. That is the role of the central bank.
Equity Bank marked 10 years and occupied their space at Church House in Kampala. For Urban TV, Amatan Kwagala.